All right, ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to be looking at a car that pretty much outlasted or lasted longer than it should have. And I have really mixed feelings about this vehicle. When I first approached it, I thought it was an IS, but this is a Lexus GS350 and it is a 2015 and it still looks good. It doesn't look like a 2023, but it's still a very, very good looking vehicle and a must see if you're looking at or looking into a used luxury vehicle. So very good lines, a very, you know, confident stance. This vehicle looks very sporty, it looks luxurious, and at the same time, it's not trying to do too much. I love the trunk spoiler. It has dual exhausts that are real, and there's not a bad angle on this vehicle. The reason why I say it shouldn't exist is because the Lexus ES 350 accomplishes the same thing. I think this is supposed to be a little bit sportier because at one point in time, the Lexus ES was like the 300 and it had like a 3-liter V6. So this one had a little bit more oomph, but there's the exhaust. I mean, this vehicle looks round and square and very capable. Cannot pop the trunk from the outside. So we'll go ahead and hop in this vehicle. And this is a 2015, so it's not super new, but I will say this, the doors feel solid. You have keyless entry, obviously, but I love the use of chrome all the way around the window. I hate when chrome is used here and not here. And one other thing I will say is that I love the wheels on this vehicle. I feel like this is like a forgotten model. These are 18s and they're a good size. But yeah, I mean, you know this is a high quality vehicle because it is a Lexus. So we'll go ahead and hop in. Taking a look, the door feels solid. It opens wide, soft touch. I love this inlay. This is like pillowy soft. You got your, that's so funny. Why is this even here? But anyway, this should have metallic tip, but it looks like it may light up when you have the headlights on, which is dope. You do have two speakers in the door and they have metal mesh grills, which is dope. I mean, this door looks solid. The design is good. It's understated, but you know, looking inside, you do have the Lexus kick plate here. You have perforated leather seats in the back. And these seats look like they sit up a little bit. And they're comfortable. You are nestled in this seat. This is, I don't know if this is a rear wheel drive vehicle, but it's definitely a two seater in the back seat. You can put two adults or three adults back here, but I wouldn't do it for a long period of time. I like the vents back here. Again, this is a 2015, so you're not going to have USB-C anywhere in sight or USB-A. You got your map pockets back here. These doors close solidly. Here's a look at the cabin from the back. This looks very, very modern. If you told me this was like a 2019, I'd believe you. So this looks more futuristic than that 2016 ES350 I showed you. I prefer the styling on that vehicle, I think, by a small margin. And I feel like there is a bit more room in that vehicle. This one, again, is going to be a little bit sportier. But, you know, you have a good look back here. This is super comfortable. I could sit back here for hours. You have LED lighting. And they discontinued this thing in 2020. But, man, I would strongly consider buying one of these. Based on the strength of the Toyota nameplate, definitely. You have three memory seat spots or options here. I wish there was metal trim on these window switches, but that's okay. You have your mirror adjustment here. Looks like you do have blind spot monitoring here. You cut it on and off there. It is warm outside, so we'll keep the door open, but we'll pop the trunk here and pop the hood here. This is an adjustable steering wheel. You have your Bluetooth here. This is a very, very simple steering wheel. All of your Bluetooth options are here, which is interesting. You don't have lane departure. I don't know if you have forward collision warning in this vehicle. You should. My 2015 Jetta has it, but I'm not sure. You do have paddles back here, which is dope, and these feel very solid. You have a analog digital display, which is more analog than anything else, but that's fine. I wish they put more buttons in this steering wheel and that it was a flat bottom, but I love the horn on this. I love this recessed screen. This is a great size screen, well done by Lexus. These controls, the ease of use is here. I'm here for that. You do have an electronic parking brake, as you can see down here. That's probably an auto hold. The start-stop button is here. This is pretty straightforward with this shifter. You do have heated and ventilated seats. So, you know, Lexus does most things well. Your cup holders are here. They do obstruct the controls here. So that's a little disappointing because of this buttonry and this dialry, touchpaddery. I don't like that. I do not like that. I think they're doing too much here. This could have just been a button and give me my cup holders in a reasonable place. There's a button for your damped and lined glove box. And I like just the slope of this hood. It's not, again, not doing too much. There's stitching here. This is soft touch here. This is a little bit harder, you know, but it's leather wrapped. You put your CDs in here. You have HD radio here. I love that this has ventilated seats 8 years ago. This carpet is actually plush. I won't show you it on my feet, but yeah. I mean, this isn't a bad place to be. Like auto dimming, rearview mirror. I mean, you have a regular sunroof here, but I'm not complaining. These seats feel comfortable and you feel well bolstered in these seats, so you could take a corner and not slide out. So we'll go ahead and take a look at the engine and the trunk. Again, this vehicle feels very, very solid, and this trunk is like massively wide. You have good space back here. You know, four people can utilize this pretty easily. And it's an automatic trunk at that. So that's super dope. You just press a button and it closes. And I love these diffuser fins here. Again, this just looks like a grown up IS sedan. And I like how the wheels are not like chrome accented. Kind of like a gunmetal color, but go ahead and pop the hood here. Obviously it has struts, and you're not going to be able to do much with this. So, yeah, the suspension kind of comes in heavily on this engine compartment, but this is a longitudinally mounted engine, which I love. It doesn't look great under here, but your battery's there. You can change that out. You could probably take this cover off and get to a couple things, but yeah, I mean, this is going to be a solid, solid engine with good power. So I would highly, highly recommend looking at this vehicle. It is a luxury sport vehicle, so it does sit a little bit lower. If you live off a gravel road, this bumper is going to give you trouble and get chipped up. So treat this baby well. But yeah, very, very good looking vehicle. You have LED DRLs here. That's dope. Projector headlights.